Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Tag team action. Introducing team number one, first from Cincinnati, Ohio. Weighing 226 pounds, Flyin' Ryan. His tag team partner from Hollywood, California. 253 pounds, Stunning Steve Austin.
Both guys walk into the ring very confident, and if I could say this, Jesse, very cocky look at him. They know that Scotty Steiner really has his back to the wall, so to speak, here.
Well, let's find out who Scotty Steiner's got for a partner.
He said he'd face both of them in DB. That's what he told us. All right, let's go back to Gary, and we'll find out.
And ladies and gentlemen, their opponents, introducing first from Detroit, Michigan, weighing 265 pounds,
right,
Scotty Steiner.
Look at
and
this.
And his partner from Marietta, Georgia, 234 pounds, Marcus Alexander Bagwell.
You know, Jeff, we talked about the youth movement in WCW, and I think based on what is happening in WCW, this was a great choice for Scott Steiner.
Well, I'll tell you what, one thing about Scott Steiner, he's got a partner that won't back down from any challenge.
That's right.
We know that, Shivani, because, you know, Marcus Alexander Bagwell sometimes as a rookie has stepped out of his league and taken on some tough, tough competitors. And, you know, Steiner maybe made a good choice here. Bagwell certainly better looking than the dog-faced gremlin, no doubt about that.
Well, it was a great choice, Marcus Alexander Bagwell as a partner. And Scotty is fired up right now after what was said by Flyin' Ryan and Stunning Steve Austin at the beginning of the program. Back in the corner. Tremendous power by Scott Steiner. What a feel out of the corner. You can tell that Scott Steiner's fired up. He's ready to take off both men, Jesse, by himself. Look at it.
Well, it's tag team wrestling. He's got to tag him in at some point in the bout, but you can bet Steiner's going to try to carry the load a little bit more and try to save Bagwell and let Bagwell have his spots in and out of the ring, but Steiner's going to carry the load, and you can see he's trying to work over Flyin' Ryan, and Steiner using his stronger weight advantage right now. And look at Flyin' Ryan going to the referee complaining, saying he's pulling my tights, ref.
If you just joined us, Rick Steiner was injured in Japan. Injured his chest or his pectoral muscle. His pectoralis major is exactly what it's called. And as they go back to a corner again, that left Scott without a partner against Austin and Bryan this week. At the beginning of the program, Austin, Flyin' Ryan came out and said, you better find yourself a partner. Scotty said, okay. And so it's Marcus Alexander Bagwell.
And right now, the ring's been cut off on Scott Steiner, and Flyin' Ryan's working him over. Good reversal right there. Whoa, Steiner catches him, picks him up quick into a press, power, body slam. Wow, brings him down from about 7 feet in the air. And a smart move by Flyin' Ryan. He rolls out to the floor.
In a situation like this, Jess, as both men and both teammates out on the floor, I would think that you would want to stay away from the power of a Scott Steiner. Hit and run, hit and run. Flyin' Ryan thinking about going back to the locker room area there.
Well, you still got to get in there and test the guy out, Shivani. Sure, you're going to try to avoid his strengths, but you still got to make him prove it. You make him prove it.
Each and every time? I mean, he's proved it over and over how strong he is.
Well, maybe he'll have an off night.
Tag is made, and here is Stunning Steve Austin. Certainly one of the most dominant champions this sport has seen.
And look at the psych job Austin's doing. He's telling Steiner, why don't you tag your goofy young partner into the ring?
All right.
Whoa, and he did it. Look at that. Steiner falls for it. I love it. He falls for it, Shivani.
So you think this was a little trick by Stunning Steve Austin to get Bagwell in?
Certainly. Get the former world champ out of there and get the rookie in there. Absolutely. It's a smart move.
Full arm drag and twist now. Back to the ropes goes Austin. For a man who certainly was butting out with confidence, he went to the ropes awfully quick. The tie-up one more time. And once again, Bagwell goes with a full-arm dragon twist and goes right to an arm bar. Marcus Alexander Bagwell, we talk about the wrestling skill, the scientific skill of our wrestlers. Bagwell certainly moving up to the forefront in that. Tremendous scientific skill. But now high impact maneuvers by Austin, pinning the youngster into the corner. Randy Anderson calls for the break. Got a break, but Austin now back to the attack again.
Well, you see how the veteran suckered the rookie. He made him think he was going to give him the clean break. He slipped in the quick kick, and now he's changed things around. And Bagwell in a lot of trouble right here. Whoa, good move there by Bagwell. He's going for the O'Connor roll-up.
Got it. One, two, and got a two count and almost upset Steve Austin there. Drop kick in the chest region. And a single leg takedown that time. Right on the arm one more time. Tremendous execution from a drop kick to a drop toe hold that time by Marcus Alexander Bagwell. The reversal and right to a side headlock. Of the power of the two men, certainly Austin has the most power.
And Bagwell's giving a pretty good performance here, but he better think about making a tag. He better not think he belongs in that ring too long with the two veterans.
Great to have you with us. As you heard just moments ago, next week, Ricky Steamboat defends the World TV title against Scott Steiner on World 1. Right now, this match, hot and heavy. Great tag team work. Double axe handle blow by the very much changed Flying Brian Pillman.
Let's call him a much more aggressive Flying Brian Pillman, a guy who knows what he wants now and is willing to do what it takes to get it.
We'll say much more aggressive. It's putting it mildly. He's had a complete change of attitude. And an elbow right between the shoulder blades that time by Austin. That has to be very painful.
Well, you know, Shivani, what it is. Sometimes when you achieve a certain status in your career, you then get to the point where you feel you can take a few shortcuts to the top. And that's where Flying Brian is. A beautiful power body slam right there. It's over.
Two and
whoa,
two.
I can't believe he got out of that.
He really did. Bagwell escaped. Nicely done by Bagwell. But waiting on him, Flying Brian up on top. Bagwell really getting mauled here. But he comes back with a blow. Right to the sternum. And now Scott Steiner. Nailing both men. Picking up Flying Brian, legal man. And now Austin, down he goes. And look, Arn Anderson out of the dressing room area. He's attacking Bagwell. And first to the post. And he hit the steel step. Bagwell's down. A cover. Saved by Austin. Apparently the hatred he has for the Steiners, and Arn Anderson still wants to collect that money offered by Doc Aguirre to take the Steiners out.
I'll tell you what, Arn Anderson coming out of nowhere has put Bagwell out of this match. And you know, earlier in the evening, Steiner said he wanted them both alone, right? I do believe he's got him by himself now.
I don't think there's any question about that. And the unfortunate thing for Scotty Steiner is he really needs to make a tag right now because he's in trouble. There he goes.
Look at this. There's no partner. Look at Steiner. He's looking around wondering, where the heck is my partner?
Right, his partner's on the floor, and that's obvious. Out. Marcus Bagwell trying to regain his composure here on the outside after being posted. There he is. Meanwhile, in the ring, they are really working on Scott Steiner.
Well, Steiner had one attempt to get over to the corner. He got to the corner, and no partner to tag, courtesy of the enforcer, Arn Anderson.
Tag is made. It is virtually a one-on-two here. Scott Steiner, the moment Bagwell went down, Scott Steiner was in trouble in the ring. Oh, big clothesline. Oh, what a tremendous clothesline on the right side ropes. There you see Bagwell. Scotty going to the corner to make the tag. Nobody there. He has no idea where Bagwell is. He can't find him. Shut up. From behind.
Well, he's Scott Steiner obviously has no idea what's happened. He goes to the corner twice, where normally the dog-faced gremlin, his brother Rick Steiner, would be waiting to make a tag. There's nobody there. And Scott Steiner, like he bragged about earlier, he said, I'll take them both on tonight. That's exactly what he's doing. It's two on one. Although I now see Bagwell has made his way back up to the apron. I don't know what kind of condition he's in.
This is a heck of a try for the youngster to even come back here. The tilt-a-whirl slam out of desperation by Scott Steiner. His partner is now there, although still, you can tell he's in no condition to get in the ring. He can't even stand up on his own 2 feet.
And Scott's looking at him. He's coming up. Oh, he kicked him.
Wait a minute.
Do you believe that?
He kicked Bagwell.
And he slams his own partner in the ring.
And he is very, very upset now.
Wait a minute. He's leaving.
Scott Steiner's walking back towards the locker room.
Unbelievable, Schiavone. He's left the little rookie in there to take on stunning Steve Austin.
There's a stun gun.
It's over.
Oh, it is over. That is it. Can you believe what we've just seen?
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of the match, the team of Flyin' Brian and stunning Steve Austin.
Okay, we'll come back with a final word. We'll get a chance. Maybe we'll get a chance to talk to Scott Steiner. Stay with us. We'll go to the magazine.